habit of going fish really low balls. And then the other thing that you do is, and it's one of, it's like the key to being able to hit the fish, is that you want to be able to cover ground low by adjusting with your torso. So you like tilt over the plate. When you get to your swing, your contact point, your left shoulder is higher than your right shoulder, causing you to have this kind of swing point, right? So you're here, your contact point, you cover the low pitch, and then you finish high, right? What you do instead is you lunge forward, you bend down, and then you go out and you get it like that.
But all the pictures I've seen that you send me.
Yes.
Yeah.
When you make contact, you should be on a straight left leg. So if the pitch is low, you should be here, you plant. When you pull your right hip through, your left leg is stabilizing. So you're like this, and then that's where your power comes from. But to cover for the low pitch, you just change the swing plane. So instead of being straight across, instead you're down and then up. Okay? So that's what you should focus on. Swinging off a straight left leg and covering low pitches by changing your swing plane instead of being straight across to be down and then up. So from where you are, low outside pitch, what we're working on, is contact point. You have to make a very conscious effort to look at it the whole time, right? Don't ever take your eyes off it until after you hit it. And then two, just making sure that you adjust by adjusting your swing plane and not using your legs. Okay. So that left foot, you're still striding a bit too much towards the pitcher. Your foot, this was your shoot point right here, and this is the same problem Jana had. Instead, what I want you to do is you load, and then I want you to step more with your foot going towards first and second, and then using that tension, you stabilize your foot.
So instead of stepping.
Yes. So what happens is when you step like this too much, you lose a lot of stability here in your inner foot or whatever. It's hard to still get as much power because now you're here, your contact point is here, and your stability is in a line going this way, right? I want you to be more compact. Step in this way. When you stride into the right hip, all of this is providing stability. So now you can go. Let that bat get down and low before it even gets to the contact point, and then it should be coming up-ish when you're about to hit it, right? So right now you're kind of there, and then it kind of gets down at the last second, and then you're hitting the ball. So exaggerate the whole uppercut motion, so exaggerate being getting low and it coming up, and then just still try to drive through the middle of the ball. And what will happen is, if you get just above the middle, you have like a heavy topspin type contact. Focus it on the ball, hit the middle of the bat and through the middle of the ball. With this this pitch being at the very outside edge and close to the front of the edge of the plate, I'm expecting it to go close to the pitcher. Don't worry, pitchers can defend themselves. Sometimes. Tip repeat. So I want to exaggerate more the adjustment with the upper body. Because right now you're still very upright, and then you kind of make the adjustment with the arms. I want you to really exaggerate, so you take your stride, you're looking at the ball, and you get low into it, and then you swing upwards almost, okay? And this way you're putting the bat on the exact same plane as the ball coming in, and you're increasing your odds of getting good contact. Further and further up. Try to swing as fast as you can, and then the other thing that you do, which you've always kind of done, is your right hip doesn't follow through as much as it should. So when you swing, you go, you make contact, but the right foot kind of stays there and you finish there. I want the right foot to follow through with your swing. When you get contact, I want your right hip going with the bat into the ball, okay? When you make contact, you're on one foot only. Don't think about dragging your right foot with you. Think about when the bat is going to hit the ball, your hips are going with it. It'll take some getting used to, and this is also the hardest to do, because if you have a chest high pitch, it's really easy, right? You go the right hip and your body is all kind of vertical, so it's easy to stay balanced. It's a lot harder to do when you bend over and you got to swing full and bring your hip through, right? So it's like it takes a lot of strength in your core. Yeah, it's fine. Too much bat speed. It's a lot of strength in your core and your hips to stabilize, and your glutes. That's why you don't skip leg day.
Every day is leg day.
Because you're so used to all these years adjusting the low pitches by coming down to meet it here, right? Which is super low percentage. But now if you tilt the body and you have a swing plane where it's on the same path as the ball, now you're going to have high percentage swings.
You just hit one kid twice. When you swung it back, when I found you, I hit you. I'm just saying the first couple of hits were really good.
Yeah, but I put the pitch deeper and more outside.
Oh, see, it's boring fault.
No, but I'm just, because that's where you might get a pitch that you have to swing at, right? So you have to stride more towards the pitch. So right now you're here, and with that left foot, you kind of go this way, right? Which means that you have to cover everything. You girls are plenty strong. I know you can hit a lot farther than you currently do. That's rude. Wow, why you hit that so hard though? Wow, this is what I get trying to help people. Hit a few more. I'll take some more. Yeah, you missed on the bat, but you got to know the ball.